Hello and welcome to this video. In this video we create a list with Firebase Firestore. At the end of this video you can add, delete and update items on a list with Svelte and Firebase. Okay, so to start I go to the GitHub page from the Svelte template and there I copy the command to download the template. Then I go into my new project folder and in this project folder I will just call npx-degit-svelte.js/template. To download my template into this folder. In the time where this downloads, I go into the Firebase console and there I just create a new Firebase project. Then in my Firebase project, I click on this web icon to create a new Firebase application. So I can give just a name and then I copy the Firebase config and also this initialize application line. So I copy this and then in my editor, I run npm install or npm I to install the dependencies that we need for our Svelte.js application. When this is done, we can just run npm install -- save Firebase to download Firebase also in our application or in our package.json file. Okay, in the time where this downloads, we can just create a new file and this file will be the Firebase.js file and this is our Firebase file. So we import Firebase from Firebase/application and then we also import Firebase/Firestore because we want to work with Firestore. Then we paste our Firebase config and also the initialize app line into this file. So this comes from the config. And then we just export our const db and this is our Firebase.Firestore function. Okay. And then we switch back into our app.svelte and there we import now this exported DB from Firebase. And then I just save this and I rename my application to list. And then I run npm run dev to check if everything works and is okay. So I click on localhost to see if my browser shows the page and here is my list. So I continue on my Firebase project. So I click on the Firebase tab and there I click on continue. And then I go into the database section of my Firebase project. And there now I can create a new Firebase Cloud Firestore database or something like this. I will use it in test mode so that everybody can just write and read everything in my database. This is not recommended for production. Okay, so when this is done, we can create a new collection. In this case, I will call this collection list because we want to create a list. Then I click on Auto ID to generate an automatic ID for the document that we create. And this is just an example. So I give it a name. The name will be list item in my list. And then I add another field and this field will be pos, like position, and I give this a number and the number will be number one. Then I create a second item. So here I click on add document and then I generate a new ID and the name will be item two and the position will be also number two. Okay, so when this is done, we can just click on this query item and then we can sort these items by the position. Okay, and now you see that this works. So we can switch back into our project and now we want to load this list in our project. So I just hide the styles because we don't need it in this case. And then we can start. So we take our database that we imported. So we type db and then we copy this collection.orderbypossask so that our list will be sorted, so that every time when our list changes we get a new snapshot of our list. So now we create a new array list, and this will be just an empty array by default, and then when this on snapshot event triggers and we get a new snapshot, we set this array list to a new, maybe it's better when I call it snap data, and so I set array list to snapdata.docs. This is Firebase specific. So here we get a list of our documents. And then in our HTML, I just make an each loop so that I can loop over each object in this array list array. And then for each item, we create a list element, and there we take the list item, and then we take the data. This is Firebase specific, and in this case, we will just show the name. And then back in the browser, I see my items. Then I switch back to the Firebase console and I create a new item. I call this item 0 and I set the position to 0 just for testing if this will now be the first item. And yes, it is. So now the positioning works. Then I rename my first item to number item 1. Okay. And now it's time to add our items over our own Svelte application. For this, I create an input field and a button. Then I create a new variable. So I type let and then I call this new item text. And this will be by default an empty string. And then we also create a function that will be triggered when we push this add button. And so now I will bind my input to this new item text variable. So to do this, we go to the input field and then we say bind value. So now every time when the value changes on the input, this will change also in this variable, and then we set this to new item text, and then on the button we say on click, and this means that when somebody clicks on this button we trigger our add item function. Then inside this function we call our db, and then we take our list collection, and then because we will add something to this list we call add, and we need to pass an object as the argument of this add function. So we take the name, and as our name we take the new item text. And then I create a new date, and this is because for my position I will just take a timestamp. So I set my position or pos to date.getTime, and this will get in JavaScript a timestamp, a Unix timestamp, and this is okay like this. So I switch to my browser to check if this works. Yay! And it looks like it works. So to verify this, I go back into the Firebase console and I see that my position is a timestamp and an item was created. So I create a second item and there is a higher number of timestamps. So this looks very nice. So now I want to add a feature that we can also delete our items. For this, I add a button into each list item. And then when we click on this button, I will call a function and I call this function delete item. And I need to call this function with an argument because I need to know which item I will delete. So I take the list item that I got from my array, and there I take the ID. And the ID, this comes from Firebase because it's an object from Firebase. So here I create my delete item function, and there I take the item ID as parameter, and then I call my DB collection list again, and in this list I take the document with the ID that I got from the parameter, and then I call just delete on this document, and Firebase will then delete this item. Okay, so now I switch back into my browser and I see my X buttons, and when I click on this X I see that the item disappear. So now we just need to add an update function. So I create a new function, I call it update item, and I take two parameters. This will be the item ID and also the new item value, so the updated value for this specific document. So I take my collection and then I take the document from the item ID parameter, and there I say I will update the name, and I will set the name to the new item value. Then I go to my list items, and there I create a span tag around my list item data name, so that when we click on this text on the item, we execute a new function, and there I take the list item, and then I set a new property, I call this edit mode, and I set this to true, and then we can create an if condition around this span, so we check if this list item is in edit mode, then we will create an input field. But before we do this, we create an else condition, because by default there is no edit mode, so edit mode is undefined, and by default we will just show our span, and then when we are in edit mode we create this input, and then we set the value of this input to list item data.name, and we create a button to update our data or our item. Okay, and now when we save this and then we go into our browser and reload the page and we click on an item, we see that nothing happens, and also there is no error, and this is because Svelte has no idea that our array changed. So we can just set our list, so the array list, to the array list, and then Svelte will know that our list has updated, and then when we reload the page and then we click on an item, we see that then our input and our button is visible, because then when we update our array list, this each loop will run again, and then the if condition with the edit mode is changed, and then the DOM will be updated. Okay, so let's continue on our update element. So here we need to send this input to Firebase when we click on the update button. So to do this, we bind this input button to a new property of our list item. So I set bind this to list item, and then I set the property to input update L, like input update element. So the property of list item is now really this input element. And then when we go to our update button, and there we say on click, so when we click on this button, we call a function, and this function will call our update item function. And there we need to set the ID of the list item element. And then as a second argument, we take this list item input update element, because this is now binded to this input. So we take this, and because this is our element itself, we need to take the value of this element And then when we save this and reload the page, and then we click on an item and we change this item, and I click on update, it seems to work, so I change also the other items. And then when I go into my Firebase database, I see that it changed also there. So thank you for watching this video. I hope it was helpful. If it was helpful, please give me a like and subscribe to this channel. And also, when you work in production, don't forget to check the security rules, because for the moment this was public, but when you just make some tests and you have finished this test, you need to change the rules that nobody can create things in your database. Good luck, and thank you for watching, and goodbye.